very disappointing results. You know, a lot of people might have thought this was going to happen. And we were trying our hardest to make sure that it didn't. Trying to give you guys the best plan we could possible to beat LSU. We were believing we could do it. Obviously, that did not happen. So very disappointed in the results. But I'm proud of our guys' effort. I thought that they practiced hard. I thought they actually made a great effort today. We just didn't have enough to go and execute at a high enough level to win the football game or be in it. But effort was there, execution was not.
Coach, Kyle asked for the point conversion. I noticed the situation leading up to the game was pretty unique. Are there any particular lessons or anything you could do when you're preparing for the game this week?
Yeah, it was very unique. The whole month had a lot of different things happening. Obviously, starting with Jeff taking the Woodman job and multiple assistant coaches also departing at that time. And then you start talking to our senior players that were really most of our production throughout the season. And guys with NFL futures that wanted to protect themselves and didn't feel like it was in their best interest to play. So they lose a lot of firepower there off the top. And then your guys, it's in flux, right? So who's gonna be the new coach? Does the new coach want me? Transport portal, you need coaches in the same position. Do I have a job in most of the bowl games? So a lot of things happening, going on, but in all honesty, I felt like the coaches stayed locked in. I felt like the players were locked in. We just couldn't get it done today.
Hey, seriously, can you sort of just assess the program going forward? And the type of foot you think Purdue is in?
I think we're in a good spot. A month ago, we played in the Big Ten Championship. So it's not like it's any like reload, rebuild, anything that needs to be done. It's just progressing and moving forward to the goal, which is eventually winning the Big Ten Championship.
This is Melissa Thomas with Florida National News. Just wanted to find out the status of Deion since he got escorted off the field in the stretcher.
Yeah, I haven't been updated on his status. The reason the stretcher came out is because there was some tenderness in the neck area. Obviously, his head hit the turf pretty hard. So they're evaluating him as we speak. We hope and pray that he will be okay.
Brian, obviously today was a result, stinks, but taking back, when this coaching staff came here, this was a program that was in the dumps. It was, bottom of the Power Fives, and to win 9 games last year, 8 this year, you kind of feel like, this group collectively accomplished quite a bit, even though, the last name right now is 60-37.
Yeah, I think so. I think for the most part, we came in kind of right away, and at least instilled some belief in the players that they can compete, that they can go out and win, that they can win big-time games. And we were obviously able to accomplish that a number of times and beat ranked opponents and pull off upsets. I think there's still some ways to go as far as trying to get to that upper echelon. Team in the Big Ten. I think it was a great year this year to get to the Big Ten Championship. Now we just need a little bit of help, help along the way to get in there. And that's kind of how the Big Ten West has been going as of late. But but I feel like the program's in a good spot. Coach Walters has inherited a program of guys that are tough, that want to play hard, that want to win. And, you know, I hope that he's able to keep it going and take it to the next level. I told you guys after the game, we want to see you guys be successful in the future. We want to see you in the Big Ten Championship next year as well. Loved my time at Purdue. A lot of great people, a lot of great relationships. Hurts that it ended this way. You know, it's kind of stuck around to try to make sure that this didn't happen. Unfortunately, it did, but it wasn't for lack of effort. I thought the coaching players, put in the effort to try to get a victory. It just didn't make it work.
All right.
TJ, I know it's fresh, but what is this game and this experience and this loss gonna do for you guys moving into the off season?
It's just gonna make us grind harder. I'm looking forward to just starting with Coach Walters and just getting back to it.
I know it's a team sport, Brian, but with any disappointment, not seeing Devin get 1,000 yards rushing.
Yeah. I kind of threw him back in there at the end a little bit because I knew we needed about 39 yards. Obviously, you don't want to risk him getting hurt, right? But you'd like to see him get to that 1,000-yard mark. We wish we could have got him there. Just we weren't, I don't know if we had a big play today, to be honest. If we could bust a few runs, a little bit of momentum. I think we could have done a few things, but this wasn't our day.
Any additional questions for left side? Was there anything playing y'all in person that was more than what you saw on film? What did you take from seeing them live?
I mean, I obviously thought we would do a lot better, but that's what you saw on film. I mean, they're athletic. They're fast, they play with speed. We knew that coming in. But we thought we could give them a much better game than we did. Very good team. Hats off to them. I think they got a bright future. And Coach Kelly has that place going in the right direction. I look for them to keep building on this for next year. Their quarterback, both those quarterbacks are really good. He's got a wealth at the position. And I think they're both coming back, so I expect Oshita to have